Do you need to make sure that your customer records are correct to the last detail? Well, then you need to know how to reconcile your records with your customers. Reconciling with your customers means that you are proving that your records match the customer records to the very last detail. But what exactly is the process of reconciling with your customers? Well, it's a three-step process. First, both you and your customer must go back to the last moment that the two of you agreed on what the balance was. Usually, that's the ending statement date of the last statement. But if you haven't been sending statements, then that will be very difficult. But assuming you have been reconciling from that point forward, then you have to consider point number two. And the second point is that the customer is responsible for reading the statement, looking at the details, and agreeing with you what the balance is as of the presented statement date. And thirdly, if there's any discrepancy that the customer notices, they are responsible for getting on the phone with you and discussing any differences in the balance or the transactions that are listed on the statement as of the statement date. So what are the specific steps when reconciling with a customer? Well, first, you have to make sure that you've been sending your customer the type of statement that allows them to reconcile. And we learned in the prior video that you can send them a transaction statement or a balance forward type of statement, because either of those two types of statements give the ability to the customer to look at each individual transaction one by one for all of the transactions that happened between the statement dates. That's what gives both of you the ability to identify any discrepancy between your records and theirs. Then, any differences found, like a missing transaction, a duplicate transaction, or even an inaccurate transaction, must be examined closely by both you and the customer. And for any differences found, both of you must go back and examine the source document of the transaction to see who made the mistake. Now, you could use one of those two types of statements to do this, but it might be better to use a report that lists the transactions in date order very clearly. And we've already learned in prior videos that the best report that lists everything regarding the customer in date order is our good friend, Transaction List by Customer. So we click Reports, Custom Reports, and go down to Transaction List by Customer. This is the best one because it lists everything that happened between you and a specific customer during the date range of the report. And you can compare each transaction one by one while you're on the phone with the customer in order to find any discrepancy. So if, for example, this particular payment is different in our records than the customer, this great report, Transaction List by Customer, allows you to double-click and open it up and go right back to the offending transaction. And then you can look closely at this payment and see exactly what the issue is, look at the source document, determine who's correct, and fix it. And once the mistake is fixed, you can print and send an updated statement or updated report to the customer to confirm that you now agree. Now that's the main idea. And this common sense procedure will fix every single customer-related mistake except one. What if the total balance of the customer is correct and each transaction listed one by one looks correct, but the balance of each individual open invoice is wrong? What mistake was made in that case? And if you figure it out, how do you fix it? Well, if you want the answer to that, you're going to have to tune in to the next video that follows this one. Until then, happy reconciling, and I will see you in the next video.